Hey everyone, Marc Windle, product manager working on SharePoint Embedded. So hey everyone online and in the room. This is awesome to be here. I'm gonna talk a little bit about vibe coding with SharePoint Embedded. First of all, if you haven't come across SharePoint Embedded, maybe check out some of the previous recordings of this series. I've done a number of sessions in there. But the short story is, it is a kind of a headless document store for your custom applications. It's built on top of SharePoint, of course, as the name implies. It allows you to write a custom app where documents get stored in your tenant. And so you get all of the security and compliance promises that you'd expect from that, as well as collaboration. And all of that content is automatically semantically indexed for it being AI native. I'm not going to go into all those details, but what I want to do today is we're going to build together our very first kind of SharePoint embedded application. It is the sketchiest demo I've ever done. We're using some pre-release software, and we're going to vibe code with one of the vibe coding apps. We'll see, you know, our mileage may vary, but we're going to do our best. Right now, we're looking at Visual Studio Code extension for SharePoint Embedded. That just helps you get started. So it makes it easy to get started. You can go into the marketplace and search for SharePoint Embedded, and I already have it installed. So I'm going to slip over into this extension on the activity pane. You can see I'm already signed in. Okay, so I've got my tenant. I got all sign in with an administrator account on here, and I'm going to create an app. So part of the kind of the information architecture of SharePoint Embedded is a container type. So we need one of those in order to get started. I'm going to call it my trial container type. And we also need an Azure Entra app registration. I'll just call that my trial app. And so what this is going to do is going to create an Entra app registration, and as well as a SharePoint Embedded container type that is associated with that. I need one container type worldwide. So in order to do that, I make one container type, and then I can install that container type on many tenants. So if I'm writing a multi-tenant kind of application as an ISV, I can do that and install it on individual tenants. Or if I'm just running a line of business app, you know, I can do that and install it on my own tenant. So looks like I'm going to need to do some MFA here. Apologies. I was originally signed in. Good thing I have my phone handy. Okay, there we go. So what I'm doing here is I made that Azure Entra app registration, and I'm just consenting to the app that I just made. And so it's going to, you know, take a second. Looks like I have that thing registered. So I'm going to expand this. This is, you know, all the stuff that we just made. I'm going to actually get something started. I'll do a bit of explaining. So there's a number of things you can do to kind of play around with this new app, SharePoint Embedded app that I made. But we can run these sample applications, set up a Postman collection, kind of explore some of the APIs. What I'm going to do here is, though, is this new, and this is pre-release, so you're not going to see it in the release version, but it's coming soon, is to copy the vibe coding starter prompt. As I copied that to the clipboard, now all of these prompts are available already online. I'm going to show you a link to that later. But what I'm going to do is get things started. This is lovable. If you haven't come across this, this is a vibe coding application. There's lots of choices out there in the market. You know, you can use GitHub Copilot or Vercel or Bolt. Lots of different vibe coding apps. If you haven't tried them, I really encourage you to kind of check those out and try our prompts. Try doing what we're doing here today. You'll be able to do that. So I pasted that prompt in there. I just want to get this going because it can take about 5 to 10 minutes to get one of these apps kind of off the ground. What this is going to do is AI is going to build an app for me. these prompts are available. If you go to aka.ms/sbe-prompts, these prompts, the one that I used is available here. So you don't have to go through the Visual Studio Code extension. You can just go look at these prompts directly if you want. But I'm going to go back now that I kind of kicked that off. I'm going to go back into Visual Studio Code. So that's running in the background here. And there's a couple of things that I want to do just to get things working. So I installed this. You can see local tenant registration. So I created a SharePoint embedded app, and now I've installed it on my tenant that I'm working on. And I can have guest apps and containers. And so containers is really the unit of storage. You can kind of think about it like a document library in SharePoint, but it's headless. My app gets to control the experiences of accessing and managing content in those containers. So that's where we put documents and things like that. First thing I'm going to do is create a container here. So I'm just going to call this. Fabricam, if I can spell. this vibe coding prompt that I put in there is an audit application. So I'm calling that Fabricam, you know, it's Contoso Audit is the name of the app. And I'm going to call that container Fabricam. So it's as though we're like auditing the Fabricam company. So let's take a look. Looks like we have that container made. And there's one more thing that I want to do. In order, once that vibe coding app is actually made, I need to add a redirect URI. You saw Paulo do that in his app before. I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm going to go right click on my intra app registration, just view it in Azure. And it may ask me to log in again. We'll see. So this is going to take me directly to the Azure portal where I can kind of manage that intra app registration. All right. There it is. And I need to add a redirect URI. So there's only one single page app redirect URI. I need to go back into Lovable. And I'm going to open up the preview, which isn't live yet. But I'm just going to copy this to my clipboard. This is just kind of that temporary URL that my app will get hosted on once it's ready. And then I'm going to add that as a redirect URI so that we can log in once it's up and running. Okay. So I'll save this to my app registration. Awesome. And let's go back into Lovable and see how things are doing. All right. So looks like it's taking a little bit of time. I'm going to go into lovable.dev and we can take a look here. Looks like it has that thing loaded. So I've got a number of projects here. I was hoping that this one would be done, but it looks like it's going to take a little while. As I mentioned, these things can take about 5-10 minutes. I've made one earlier. I've actually made a number of these. We can check this out. So see, these are just the projects that I've made in Lovable. Same prompts. You can iteratively work on these things. And so there's actually a number of prompts in this library that I showed you earlier. You can add different types of capabilities, you know, different types of container, permission management. Really, it's really quite straightforward. You know, you can use kind of plain language and get this to add features to your app. So this is one that I've made earlier. We'll check this out. We can play with it. And maybe the one that we made live today is going to be ready. So I signed in here. And here, this is this is working on a different container type. So I have two containers here representing kind of the individual audits that I would do. When I open one of these, I'm going to open up the Fabricam 2024 container. You can see I've got a number of documents in here. I'll open up this kind of documents folder. Right out of the gate, you know, with that one prompt, you're able to get this kind of application experience, really. And you can go look at the source code and see how it works under the hood and how the APIs are being called for SharePoint Embedded. But you can do a whole bunch of things here, like upload files. And it really gets you, you know, to a point where you have like a working application in, you know, just a few minutes that can manage content in SharePoint Embedded. And not just manage content, but you have Office collaboration. So I can open up this right from my application and we can, you know, collaborate, co-author, at mention, and share documents here in Word, Excel, and PowerPoint online, as well as desktop. And then we have with SharePoint Embedded, there's a built-in previewer client. So you can preview PDFs, images, you know, all sorts of different, hundreds of different file types, as well as streaming video. In fact, I have a video here. So let's just take a look at this. All you have to do is drop a video file in a SharePoint Embedded file storage container. All of the encoding is handled for you. So you can stream video directly from your application with just a few lines of code by putting content in there. So this is the kind of app that you can build right away. Looks like this one is still working. Again, it can take, you know, 5, 10, sometimes 15 minutes. It doesn't always work the first time, but you can iteratively say what your problem is and ask it to fix it. Again, you can do this with lots of different types of vibe coding apps that are out there and available. I really recommend you try it. It's a great way to kind of prototype something. It might not be the way you build, you know, your production application, but if you're looking to build a prototype and get started quickly with SharePoint Embedded, I recommend you try it out. And I'll put the links to kind of all the information, you know, the extension and the prompts that I showed into the chat, and hopefully we can get those on the YouTube post as well. So that's it for me. Thank you very much for joining. Good luck vibe coding.
Excellent. Thank you, Mark.